Hi, and welcome to the Product Design Show. I'm Allison Topperwine.
And I'm Vince Penman. Today, we're going inside NASCAR to see high-performance design in action.
As all you red-blooded racing fans know, NASCAR is about racing real cars, not those sissy one-seaters nobody could ever take grocery shopping. We recently spoke with Bill Ferguson, senior designer at NASCAR's Tech Center in North Carolina. He told us about one particular design challenge, and here it is. The nose of the 2010 cars was designed for performance, and while it does the job exceptionally well, it doesn't look like the Impala in my driveway.
Same with the front of the Ford Fusion. See how it has those struts running from the front bumper down to that splitter on the front? That's definitely not production. Same with the big air hole in the front of the car. NASCAR fans like their race cars to look like the cars they see on the road.
The NASCAR version of the nose serves some important aerodynamic purposes. It holds the splitter about an inch off the ground, and it provides venting to the front brakes to keep the pads, calipers, and rotors cool. We recently spoke with Bill Ferguson, design engineer at NASCAR. Here's what he had to say about the design challenge.
The goals with the redesign were to improve the car's aesthetics, making it look more like a production vehicle without compromising performance in any way. We had eliminated the front struts. We were able to pull the splitter in underneath the nose, and we had more brand identity in the grille area.
To get started, Bill designed six different sketches of what the nose might look like. Those were run by a panel to see which one would be most favorably received by race fans.
Here's an image of Bill's redesign, showing an isometric view of the new supports that were built to do the job of the struts and support the nose. You can also see the complex surface of the new brake ducts. Note that the splitter is still there, but is going to now be hidden by the nose.
The nose design itself is a complex shape that had to match the performance characteristics of the old nose. After all, race fans weren't going to be happy with slower cars at Daytona. Bill told us about the design process.
When designing the nose for 2011, we used Creo Parametric, and we used several features that software module has to offer, such as sketching, part modeling, assemblies, and style feature specifically. After testing in the wind tunnel, and we would make a change to the nose, and once we felt that that nose was close to what we wanted to produce, I would export files and send them directly to our manufacturer, and they would use those CAD files to in turn make the composite part directly.
After doing all that homework, the car was ready for testing on the track. The great news is that it performs every bit as well as the benchmark, and there is no question that it looks like it should. The reaction from the fans has been nothing but positive. You can get your NASCAR on by checking out the full power of Creo's parametric modeling software. It's the same software Bill Ferguson and the NASCAR engineers used to redesign the nose we showed in this episode. Just go to ptc.com/go/Creo Parametric.
If you like the show, please give it a like on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, or give us a rating on iTunes. We'll see you next week for more great product design engineering.